It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. In this project, you use a Hadoop cluster both for serving analytics and for processing and transforming data. The data is currently stored on HDFS in Parquet format. The data processing jobs run for 6 hours each night. Analytics users can access the system 24 hours a day. Phase one of the project is to quickly migrate the entire Hadoop environment without a major re-architecture. Phase two will include migrating to BigQuery for analytics and to Cloud Data Flow for data processing. You want to make the future migration to BigQuery and Cloud Data Flow easier by following Google recommended practices and managed services. What should you do? One of the first things that I think of when seeing this question is how long the question is. Typically, you've got about 2 hours to finish the exam and about 50 questions, which leaves you with a little bit over 2 minutes to answer each question. So be careful about how much time you spend reading the entire question and sometimes the options, which also might be long. So make sure that you adjust your time to finish or complete the entire exam on time. So plan it out well. And if you're taking too much time on one question, remember there will be other questions that are shorter, but don't take an excessive amount of time because there's only a limited amount of 120 minutes typically that you have. The key parts of the question, we have a Hadoop cluster. We are using for two purposes, for serving analytics and for processing and transforming data. If you read this question again, it is not very clear, just two. It looks like it is serving analytics is one, processing is one, and transforming is another. But some answers or some answer options give you the indication that is actually two parts. The data is currently stored on HDFS and it's in Parquet format. We want to quickly migrate this to Google Cloud. So the entire Hadoop environment should ideally be lifted and shifted to Google Cloud without redoing a lot of the architecture. But we also want to consider phase two, where we will be changing some of the processing and transforming and the analytics part to using BigQuery and Cloud Data Flow. So to prepare for that, we also want to use Google recommended practices as we do phase one. Given those project requirements, let's look at the options. Option one is to lift and shift Hadoop and HDFS directly to Cloud Dataproc. Now, Cloud Dataproc is the managed version of Hadoop, and therefore that is the recommended approach. However, HDFS is not recommended when you're moving to Google Cloud. HDFS requires the storage and the compute to be together, and that doesn't scale very well. You will also have to manage the hard disks that are attached to these VMs, and again, that involves more operational work, which is not recommended. Therefore, we will eliminate option A. Option B is to lift and shift Hadoop and HDFS to Compute Engine. Lift and shift Hadoop is the approach. However, to Compute Engine would be a terrible option. This would pretty much be moving your exact on-prem environment to Google Cloud without getting any of the advantages of the managed services within Google Cloud. You're still going to be very operationally intensive, where you'll have to manage each of the VMs, scaling on it, and also the disk attached to it, which will have HDFS. Therefore, option B is not a good option at all for our requirement. We will therefore eliminate option B. Option C suggests that we create a single Cloud Dataproc cluster. That's looking good because Dataproc is the managed service for Hadoop. And on that single cluster, we support both analytics and data processing. The data itself is on a cloud storage bucket where we store the Parquet files that were previously stored on HDFS. So the first part of the option to use cloud Dataproc is the right one, because Hadoop is managed automatically as Dataproc within Google Cloud. So that part is good. So Hadoop Dataproc is recommended. HDFS to cloud storage is also recommended. Whereas HDFS requires the compute and the storage to be together, with cloud storage now we have a centralized place where we have scalable data that is also persistent. So even with worker nodes coming and going, with worker nodes scaling, we will still have a place which is centralized that all of these worker nodes can connect to. Therefore, cloud storage is the recommended option when you're doing Hadoop / Dataproc on Google Cloud. Given that, option C looks good right now, and we are going to park it as a potential right answer for later. Now let's look at option D. Option D is also very similar. It again recommends Google Cloud Storage to store your Parquet files instead of using HDFS. That is very good. It also recommends that we use Dataproc to do the lift and shift from on-prem Hadoop. The only difference is that option C suggests that we use a single Dataproc cluster, whereas option D suggests that we use separate Dataproc clusters. Which of these is the better option? Between these now, we will have to see, is it better to use a single cluster, which is usually the option used on-prem, or do we use a separate clusters, which is ideally not used on-prem, because it just means that there is more to manage and administer when you're working in your own cloud. So on-prem, there tends to be a single Hadoop cluster because it reduces the operational admin tasks. You manage the cluster in one central place. But this is not the recommended approach when you move to Google Cloud. On Google Cloud, you can have a use and dispose model where every time you want to run a job or when you have use for a cluster, you can bring it up maybe using scripts or using a predefined template in YAML that will bring up this cluster, run the processing job, and then dispose it after a while. So the recommended approach on Google Cloud is to use separate Dataproc clusters for separate jobs. Therefore, the right option for this question would be option D, to use separate cloud data clusters and to also store the data in a centralized place on cloud storage, which is also scalable and persistent. Now it's time to subscribe to all the great content we've got lined up for you to learn Google Cloud and to help you with the certifications.